Hi, everybody. It's Monday. It's Mixed Media Monday, and I'm Tracy Weinzappel. I am looking at my hair and thinking I probably should have done something with it today. But anyway, that's okay. I can't see. I think I'm due for a haircut. But you're in my studio, and I'm not sure if my moderators are here, but Angie is now a moderator, and Angie knows how to reach me, so should we need a moderator. So I'm not too worried. There we go. Okay, so it's Monday. It is November 30th. It is the last day of November, and then we're moving into the last month of December. We're moving into December, which is the last month of 2015. I actually cannot believe it. Like, this entire month. Oh, excuse me. I'm going to turn this because all you're going to see is Walking Dead. All right. So it's the last month. We're going into Christmas. I'm so excited. We all survived Thanksgiving. Yes? Everybody good? I know Angie could use some prayers for her dad. And I know that stinks. And let me see what I can tell you about my Thanksgiving. It was really quiet. It's kind of unusual because we normally have family here, so I normally have a very full household. But we had no family, and my kids all went to their dad's, and John's son went to his... It's somebody's birthday. It's Latina 15, New York, NY, I'm assuming. It is her birthday. Happy birthday. We had no kids for Thanksgiving. And a couple years ago, we started this little tradition of when we have quiet Thanksgivings, we go sightseeing in San Diego because the parking is good and there's hardly anybody down there and the restaurants are open. So we first went to Little Italy, and then we drove to Seaport Village, if you're familiar with San Diego, which is very touristy. We did a little window shopping, and then we went to dinner, and we had dinner with a nice gentleman by the name of Stan, who was 61 years old. I invited him, walked over to the table. We thought, he's eating alone. So I said to him, I didn't want to, invade his privacy, but I just thought, it's Thanksgiving. Nobody should eat alone. And we joined him. We asked him to join us, and he did. He was really happy. So we had a really lovely dinner with Stan. And then we came home and had dessert with all the kids. So I didn't have to cook a big dinner, which was just really unusual. I went into it just very thankful that I didn't have to. And then when the day hit, I went, oh, crap, I really wish I had a turkey. But I survived. And now we're going into Christmas, and I am going to pull the same keep it simple motto because we are taking our first family vacation. Thank you, Rain. It was really nice. It was really nice to meet somebody, too. We're taking our first family vacation, so I'm not putting a tree up. Okay, and I keep saying that to myself so that I don't put a tree up. So we're not putting a tree up, okay? We're kind of skipping Christmas. No, we are going away for Christmas. We're taking our whole family's going to Costa Rica. So we're going to be beaching it. I just ordered a bathing suit in the middle of November. You know how depressing that is? And I ordered it on Cyber Monday, and I had to order it so that I can try it on in the comfort of my closet. I didn't want to go to a store and try on bathing suits right now. There's nothing more depressing than putting on a bathing suit this white. Yes, Brenda just said, I'm thinking of my word for 2016. I'm thinking of my word too, because my word for this year was right, W-R-I-T-E, not R-I-G-H-T. That'd be weird. But we always do that for the first Monday of the year. And I've got to look at my calendar because there's a couple of Mondays I'm gone. So be thinking of your word of the year. I don't know. I haven't gotten there yet. I have just been going. Yeah, last week was my twin's birthday on the 20th, dad's birthday on the 23rd, brother's birthday on the 24th, uncle's birthday on the 25th, and then Thanksgiving. So once I get through that week, I then regain my consciousness. And there's no big gift swapping this year because your gift is, a vacation. I know, I can't wait. I'm so excited. My word 3 years ago was breathe. I loved that word. That was one of my favorite years of words. Okay, I need to be twins tonight. Oh, I know. Tape that. You can't. Well, you could also watch me tomorrow. Okay. I'm not going to be hurt if you watch me tomorrow. So, if you went to my blog today, I posted late today, but I was commissioned to do two pieces of art for a friend of mine. Really wanted art for her office and said, I really want you to do this. So I did the two pieces last year, and she asked me to do three more pieces. So I went through how I did the planning stages, because once you ship somebody the artwork, you really don't have it anymore. And I gotta take my rings off. They're feeling kind of loose and they're wiggling around. So anyway, you can go to my blog and see how that is. Maybe Angie can throw the link up there. I did it. I planned it out in Word. And so today she said, can you send me that plan again? And so she literally had the engineer in her office. She sent me pictures as they were going up. And she works in an engineering office. And the engineer literally put them on the wall the way I mapped them out. So it was so cool. And today I don't really have a plan. Big surprise. I've been in the midst of kind of no mojo and going through the motions of some just paint stuff for work and paperwork and blah, 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 blah. Thank you, Rain, for saying the paintings are wonderful. Means a lot. And so I haven't really been feeling creative. A lot of people ask me, where do your ideas come from? Do you always feel creative? The answer is no. So the show must go on. And I definitely can't say to you guys, okay, sorry, not going to happen tonight. That's just not the way it's going to work. So we're just going to paint. And this will just be the way it goes tonight. Fair is fair. And then I think I told you last week that I approved, I think it was Wednesday that I approved everything, but my approval for my 7 new stamps was done last week too. So exciting, exciting, exciting stuff. So my mom and dad are not here tonight. I think they're not going to be, because my mom texted me less than an hour ago and said they had just gotten back from North Carolina, which means they drove all day. So I don't hold them accountable. So anyway, I was showing off. Oh, let me move this up. Otherwise, it looks like. So I will be sharing these on my blog. This was an accident, creative accident. So glad. Has about 12 layers, and it almost ended up with gesso over the top of it. It was kind of funny. This is a winter project, which you'll hear more about soon from me. And I'm playing around. See, I was crackling my heart. So these were winter projects. I think this is what has me stumped. So I just want nothing to do with winter projects. So, let me get some lights, camera, action. So, I don't know what we're going to do tonight. Oh, yay for the stamps, not for your parents being there. So, if you are not, what kind of book is it? This is, didn't I give the link? I will give the link tomorrow, Rain. It's a Strathmore Mixed Media soft cover. And sometimes I have to reinforce the bindings with some tape, but it's really been pretty good. It's pretty good. So I will post this on my blog. Might not be tomorrow, the next day, but I'll put the name of the thing. I'll take a picture of it because now it's just really weathered. Okay, so I think that's it. I think we're going to paint. I'm going to find my mojo. And I'm going to find another camera. That would be the first thing. And then I'm going to find... Oh, there we go. Oops, stop shaking. Step shaking. Okay. All right. The good news is I did get my Christmas card done. I got all of the kids together. I got my Christmas card ordered and done. I send Christmas cards out every year, and I wasn't about to give that one up. So I didn't give that up. Not yet. All right. I'm just going to adjust this just a hair. Okay. Everybody can hear me, right? So I'm going to do an 11 by 14 mixed media piece of paper, and I'm going to probably have to lift this up a little bit. I just realized it's kind of
All right, I've been doing other things. All right. Is this good? Is that good? I'd like to cover that one giant ball that's over my. No, that one? Yeah, maybe that'll work. Okay. That'll work. How about that? All right, so what I'm going to do first, because I was going to crack all this background, but of course I forgot, which that is not a good idea. But that's okay. Because sometimes, I did this the other day, cheated. There we go. So, look at. All right. So I'm just going to cut this. This is tissue paper. And sometimes. Yeah, that'll work. Yeah, that'll do it. Okay. I don't know what I'm doing, but I got that far. Okay, here we go. What we need is some. I'm going to put some matte medium down. Just glober globber this on. Okay, Olivia is. Oh, my apron! Thank you. I have a new sweater on. Did not want to ruin that. Speaking of which, I got to finish my other apron and get that posted. Okay, she said blacks, purples, and blues tonight for Olivia. Oh, and I want to make mention, Angie needs to remind me. Deco Art, and I think the sale is on for the next 4 hours. So get over there. If you do want Deco Art products, I think they're, don't quote me, 30% off and free shipping if it's over $30 or something, which is a phenomenal Cyber Monday deal. Okay, so I must be into the blues too because I realize my matte medium, my paintbrush has blue in it. That's funny. Okay. Oh, it's a phenomenal deal. There we go. So this is what I just make sure you get the edges too. Ooh, that's a lot of matte medium. Oh well. Get me a discount. All right. So I'm going to I missed a spot here, so I'm gonna do do do. Okay. Oh. You see that? All right. There we go. Angie, thank you. That is a phenomenal deal. And I know it's probably not a great idea. It's so funny. My girlfriend says, oh, there's my hair in there. Oh, so you're also going to get hair in there. My girlfriend said, it's Cyber Monday, and all I've done is order pajamas and bras for myself. And I was laughing, and I'm like, well, I ordered bathing suits for myself, and I had to order quite a few of them because I'm just gonna return them all. But I'm not a big, I don't like to shop for bathing suits. Who does? Oh my God, I don't even think you're Christie Brinkley. You like shopping for them, but anyway. And then I'm taking matte medium over the top of it. Do you see all that squishy whooshy I put in it? Ooh, make sure you get the air bubbles out, even though I don't think it matters. All right. Lots of air bubbles in there. Oh well. You don't care. All right. And then we're going to dry that. Yeah, there's my DNA. Go to my studios page. I posted a link, I believe, on there. You can click it from there. Okay, I'm just gonna tear this while it's a little. Oh, I forgot some. It's a really great deal, though, I have to tell you. So if your husband gets you something for Christmas, and you can just go order it and say, "Honey, thank you." Stick paint in your stocking. Makes a great gift. Ooh. I hope Olivia's running to go get her tissue paper. Mom, are you looking for tissue paper for her? So I'm just tearing this off aimlessly. And then I'll take a heat gun to it. I know that's what is happening on this. It looks kind of nifty. You just want to make sure you get the edges. See, and it kind of tears right off. Phew. So Santa's got to find us in Costa Rica, sunning my buns. Or according to my family, I'll be ziplining. But according to my family, they don't actually know what I'll be doing because I'm not going to be ziplining. Remember that little thing about heights? Really have no desire. But my family seems to think that if I don't go ziplining in Costa Rica, I will have missed out on the opportunity of a lifetime. They're crazy. I think my opportunity is by keeping my big fat feet on the big fat ground. So if you see me ziplining in the middle of, see, I don't even feel like tearing this off. So all I'm going to do is just bunch it up. Here we go. In order to not have to, I'll just do this. All right, perfect. And there's a bunch of air bubbles right there, so. All right. Goody. Yes, anybody new tonight? Great question, Angie. Sorry, I am just, look at me. If you're new, I didn't think I said who I am. Well, I'm Tracy. If you're watching, though, you probably know who I am, just because you probably didn't wander on here aimlessly. And you're in my studio, by the way. And this is real time. This is actually happening in this minute. What you see is actually happening. There are no, this is not rehearsed. You are not required to go order anything from DecoArt. We just thought we'd mention it because it is an awesome sale. If, okay, oh, if found you dead. What? I found you dead. All right. Oh, that is where I'm going to be sipping a pina colada. Oh my God, it just sounds amazing and fattening and lovely. Yeah, there'll probably be a lot of that happening. Okay. I'm spending way too much time trying to get this perfect when I said don't make it perfect. All right. Now, the trick of this is to... you do want to make sure the edges are glued down because you don't want stuff coming up off your paper. So, that's all I'm doing. And none of this you will see. All right. Goody, goody, goody. Oh, there is my hair. Look at that. It is just right smack dabby doo in there. Kind of would like to get that out of there, but... Well, if somebody buys this piece of artwork, it literally will have my DNA. So if somebody would like to clone me years from now, this will be the piece you're going to want to mention. It'll be like, all right, stop jacking with it and just dry it. Okay. I found you, Dee Dee. I'm sorry. Okay, Dee Dee. Oh, that's way better than I found you dead. Oh my God, well, it's Dee Dee's first and last time watching this show. Where are you from? I found you, Dee Dee. Well, that's a new one. Okay, she's laughing. Oh, that's funny. Oh, sorry. Ah, that's so funny. I found you dead lying by the side of the road. Okay, so if it's your first time watching, the whole premise is to put tissue paper and booger it all over the... No, I'm kidding. It is to use what you have. I will tell you what paints and what colors I'm using, and you're not required to go get them. I do believe that we buy a lot of stuff and we don't use it. I'm going to tell you all the stuff I love. Oh, God. Louisiana. Okay, so if somebody's looking for somebody in Louisiana, not around, I found you dead, might know where they're located. Okay, great question. Teresa with Teresa Met Wife just asked, DecoArt Media Colors, name your favorite. Could you name some of your favorites? Okay, so funny, my back of my business card, I had to name my favorite color. Here's my favorite color, cobalt turquoise hue. That's my favorite color. That's number one. So I'll talk about other colors. Do you want more? Or you just want... First, we need to call 911 and get somebody over to Louisiana because there's a body. Okay. It's so funny. I'm sorry. Okay, more colors. Let's talk colors. I love colors. Probably all the colors that are sitting on my desk right now. I love Prussian blue hue. That's probably here. Love that color. I think you gotta have a white, a Payne's gray, carbon black. You probably want colors, not just me viewing up. Green gold. Love me. Oh, pyro red. Cannot live without it. Do I have it? I do have it. Hold on, I don't want to burn a hole through this while I'm talking, which is rightfully possible. Yeah, pyro red is Ferrari red. Love it. Okay. Quin gold is a good one. Yeah, I do use quin gold. I used to make fun of quin gold, but I don't make fun of it anymore. Prussian blue hue and Payne's gray are love. If you got it, if quin violet, I love, and magenta. Oh, sorry, I missed this one. Cobalt teal hue. Hope you're writing. You're asking me to pick my favorite kids, and it's so funny because it's like I can't. But yeah, green gold. These are the colors I use the most, I will tell you. I do go back to my... Hands of Yellow Medium. Oh, that's Hands of Yellow Medium and Diary Lied Yellow. Oh, you also, if you mix colors, you want to have your primaries. Your primary cyan. You want to have red, yellow, primary yellow, primary cyan. Oh, gal. Okay, did I name enough, or do you want me to keep going? Because I pretty much could name them all. I'm really making sure this is dry, or I'm burning a hole through it, one of the two. So if you have any scragglies on the side, no, that's not. It's not that color, trust me. There's a few colors that are like that, though. So if you get any that you just did not, any of the tissue paper off, you can just sand it off. Comes off real easy. See. Okay. So now you have some built-in texture. And, yeah, I love them all, I actually have to say. Oh, could you mod me again? I had to reboot, and apparently, yes, I can, Angie. There you are. It was writing them down. Oh, thanks for, Angie, for typing them. Oh, perfect. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I was literally just looking. Oh, tight and buff. Gotta have a white and gotta have a buff. Oh. Sorry, Angie. You could have texted me. You know me. You know me, I'll talk colors all day long. All right. So that's really good. I know. Will you, you guys think, I would think you'd have all my colors memorized because you see and hear me every single week, right? All right. So what I wanted to try this week was, I had this bad boy out. Well, I need to have a background. That I need to have a background. Let's talk backgrounds. I want to make like some triangular. I'm not really big on, well, I don't do a ton of Christmas stuff, so don't quote me, but I wanted to do something with the word joy and three like very simple Christmas trees. I'm not going to go overboard. You're not going to get any massive three-dimensional works of art Christmas trees. So if you want those, you might want to go tune into another live Mixed Media Monday show right now. I want to keep it simple. Yeah, I love all the blues in the color palette. That's what Angie just said, and I love them too. So as far as background colors here, since we were just talking turquoises and blah, blah, blahs and blah, blah, blahs, I think I'm just going to stick with those blah, blah, blahs. Okay? And we're going to hope. I love that Louisiana's here live. Everybody's here. All right. Oh, Olivia likes the tissue paper. Okay, good. Yeah, I think she'll like this when it's done. So this is so funny. I did this the other day. I was just playing around with this book, and then this is what I did in this background, which I'll share tomorrow. So you can see it kind of just gives itself. I didn't do a ton of it, but then I had a bunch of mistakes. So this is layer after layer after layer of like, and then I almost just gessoed over the entire thing because I was so like, I give up. But then I decided, no. I went with it. And that's what we're going to probably do today. Unless we missed this. Nah, I could miss this. But no. I know a lot of people are ordering the misters too. Okay. I don't know what I feel like doing. That's the problem. Maybe that's the ticket. That's why I don't. All right. But you know what? That's half the fun. So give these a shake. So if you use, I'm using acrylic paint. If you're new to the show, like Dead or Alive is, this is the media paint from DecArt. I love it, of course. I work for them, so I just love it. Okay. Oh, you know what I need? Baby wipes. Sorry, be right back. I have none. Sorry about that. I remembered I just used the last of my baby wipes. And okay, that's good. Okay, good. So all those colors I just listed to you, I might as well just pull them out and start using them. Oops, no. Oops. Okay. Okay, hold on. Sorry about that, got a tech. Okay. Hey, we're doing a show here. Oops, that's a mixture of colors. That's okay though, don't panic. Like, you ever gonna panic? This might be one of those nights where I just go, oh crap, let's just gesso over the whole thing. Okay, so the cool thing about this is we have all of that really, the cool thing is when you mix these two lovely colors together, they make a beautiful green. All right, so we'll just keep with that. And if I have to move this, this was diary lid yellow, or diary lid, I might be, oh shoot, I don't mean to use that. And this is the cobalt teal hue that I'm just, okay. So I am just giving myself my paintbrush is kind of wet too, which is kind of cool. I was going to wet this down, but with the matte medium and the tissue paper, and I don't really want to start pulling it back too much because I could pull the tissue paper right off of that. I don't really want to do that right now. But what you can do is you can take a baby wipe and that will allow you to blend all of these colors in. Do you see that? Because that matte medium acts as a sealer. So we're able to kind of work with the paint for a little while. It's not going to just go right in. Got it? Just don't rub too hard because you're going to rub the tissue paper right off, and you really don't want to do that, do you? All right. Yeah, you guys should go blow up that DecoArt website right now. That way they know. So I'm using all these colors we just talked about. And this is my favorite color. This is cobalt turquoise hue. So I know this, I said I was going to do a Christmas page. We are going to do a Christmas page. I think we're going to do a Christmas page. I don't absolutely know we're going to do a Christmas page. I'm hoping we're going to do a Christmas page. Okay. Okay, I'm glad Angie could answer these questions about, and I just heard from Lori, so she cannot be here tonight. But thank you, Angie, for filling in. And Angie's got enough on her plate, and now she is filling in for me. So now she is just lovely, lovely, lovely. So the thing about these fluid acrylics is a little bit goes a long way. So you see this little plate that I'm using? Angie, you're the only moderator I have. So if you are under the, we're fine with whatever you're doing. All right. Go ahead and ask Angie about 42 questions right now. So if you're wondering, I'm just going to take that baby wipe, and that is how I'm going to blend everything in, okay? So that matte medium, I didn't even have to gesso over this. This yellow is so dark. I just want to bring that back. And you know how I'm going to bring that back? This is how I'm going to bring it back. See, these are the colors I said you had to have, right? Now you have to have like a white or a translucent white, one of the whites. You got to have a white. So I'm just going to water this white down just a hair. And then I've got a lovely little, so if you're wondering what this is, I get those from the Dollar Tree. They're like those meat serving platters. All right. So all you got to do is bring some white back into this, and you'll just whitewash right over the top of it, and you can pull back, and you know that yellow is just tremendously bright for me, but you can do it over the whole thing. And see, we made some greens in there. All right, we said this was going to be Christmassy. I don't know what the hell I'm thinking. Heck, I was thinking, but yeah, we are. Si, senor. All right. Although I gotta tell you, I'm feeling more creative than I have in the past, I don't know how many days. You know the problem is I haven't written. I made my word for 2016. No, we're in 2015. Write. And I love to write. So if you go to my blog, you'll see I will occasionally just meander with just stuff I feel like saying. And it's kind of pretty. This is kind of beautiful. Anyway. Yeah, I was really looking for something a little more golden. Maybe I should have just used gold like a Nimrod. Look at that. There is gold. It's metallic. I wonder what happens if I blend this in. You know what? Nobody knows unless I try. I was looking for a little more gold, and I went a little not gold. Let's just see what happens. Oh, yeah. Okay. That was the color I was shooting for. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to do this. Just put it in there with my fingers. There's gold. This is metallic gold, if you guys were wondering. There's metallic colors too. That is gorgeous. Mm. So you can bring that gold in anywhere you want. All right, look at that. There we go. Okay, so So anyway, back to what I was saying. I'm trying to multitask here. I really did want this to be gold, so now I'm just going to... There we go. Okay, we found gold. We found gold at the end of that rainbow. Good. And I'm just going to do one more dabbly dip. So what I'm doing, when you see me just take my fingers to it, I'm just kind of rubbing it in. Now I'm going to talk to you, it's pretty. I think it's really pretty. Do you think? Okay. Oh, There, do you write the quotes at the end of your posts? They're really beautiful and inspiring. Thank you, Rain. No, I don't write. I write some of them. A lot of them I find embarrassing. I'm a quote collector. I'm a quoteaholic, pretty much. And oh, thank you. I love your meandering writings. They're be Oh, thank you. Sometimes I feel great about it, and sometimes I wonder what the heck. I'm not a trained, psychologist. Why am I writing this? But it just feels good for me. It's a type of therapy, I guess, for me. And it's cheaper than therapy. I just pay for my blog. All right. What do you think? So this has got a little bit of a metallic luster to it now that I've added that, because it is a metallic gold. All right, let's put the baby wipes away. I really like that background. In case you were wondering, I really like my background. Yeah, I collect so much stuff, and I put them in folders, and then I. But a lot of some of them I write. If I'm feeling something, I'll write it. I think I used last week's quote. So this is my jelly plate. I don't know, a lot of people have jelly plates, and I'm gonna get some. I almost want like a thin paper, a deli paper, or a rice. I am going to use like a deli paper here. Okay. And I have this idea. I don't know if it's going to work, but I just got some really thin paper. Okay, here we go. So this is a jelly plate. And if you're not familiar with a jelly plate, they're cool. Here we go. Thank you for saying you love that background. So now what I have in mind, da 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 dum dum. Okay. Is this color, and I want to try a purple. See, I've really been into. I'm being challenged to use a couple colors. So, and then I'm going to try some phthalo blue. Okay, I don't know if this is going to work, but you know what? If it doesn't work, you just trash it. Who cares, right? You're not paying by the minute for this, right? All right, here we go. So I'm going to just take my brayer. This is just a test. This is only a test. This could actually go to hell in a handbasket in about 6.2 seconds. So don't, if it doesn't go right, don't panic. I don't, like I said, this could just go poo-poo. Go poo-poo with a woo-hoo. I'm just taking some of those colors I actually just used, and I'm putting them on my, I don't really need to make it this big, but maybe I'll just pick out my favorite part of it. I'm just gonna make a couple of. I'm not a big. I love jelly painting. I do it, but people go in there and they add 52,000 designs, and then they get the negative and the positive, and then they draw a face in it. My brain doesn't work exactly like that. I'm all about simple. If you're wondering how I jelly plate, there you go. Really into the simple. But I'm gonna do something like this. I'm just gonna. Okay. See, told you I listened to the simples. That's bubble wrap, for heaven's sakes. Can't get any simpler than that. All right, I'm just cutting a piece of the bubble wrap off. I don't need 14. All right. All right. I don't know if that's gonna work. I don't know if that's exactly what I had in mind. And then I'm going to do this. So you will typically not find me like doing 22 negatives. I usually just go with what I make. But I don't know if it can be dark enough. I don't know if you're gonna see it. I might need to use a rice paper, but let's see what happens. We just gotta. Oh, no, not enough paint. Okay, that's okay. Okay, I know what I did wrong. See, I told you. Really great demo, Tracy Ann. Really good demo. Yeah, everybody loved that one. I didn't even show it to you. That's how bad the demo was. Oops, come back here. Well, I didn't use enough paint. Oh, I didn't mean to use that much paint. Well, that's okay. Well, that's okay. Even better demo. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Cool. This is going to be wild and fancy free. See, this is what I did, and it wasn't dark enough. I just did like three. That's how I did my last three backgrounds, and I loved it. So that's what I'm shooting for again. We're going to try it again. You can only do what you can only do here. Okay. That's kind of cool. Cool. Okay, now we do it again. See, I could do this all dang day. I'm just trying to get three simple triangles out of this, so don't. But again, all right. There's enough. See, Angie, the bubble wrap is just for you. All right, ready? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what I wanted. Okay, put that to side. Put that to the side, not put that side. All right, now I need a piece of scrap paper. I don't have any scrap paper, so I will just take a piece of white paper. Here we go. Here, this is for my work. I know, everybody says take the negative, blah, blah, blah. I'm not doing that. I could, but I just put that on a piece of work paper, so I guess I'll make sure I reprint that memo for tomorrow's meeting. So I'm just going to wipe this off because I want three different colors. Yes, yes, that's what we want. Just taking a little baby wipe to it. This thing feels like a giant Jell-O shot, if you're wondering what that feels like. Okay, giant Jell-O shot. Can't go wrong with bubble wrap. You are so fantastically right. All right, we need a greenish blue. This should do it, and I'm not. So I've got to do this again. But pretty much all you do, you don't need to like. I'm not wiping my brayer clean or anything. I'm just gonna go for it again. All right, see, and I don't care if the colors mix. I mean, they're all colors I like, so. Yeah, but we're shooting for a different one in this one. Where's that dark? Here we go. Yes. And now I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to make sure I just get that nice and wet. Glad I'm. That is cool. And then I'm going to take the bubble wrap and I'm going to take some white paint and I'm going to see if this will work. I'm going to. I'm just painting on the bubble wrap as we speak. Okay, yep, that's what I wanted. Oh, yeah. Okay. Nothing too crazy. Okay. Got it? Got it. Okay. Another piece of paper. Another piece of, here it is. So we're going to make three trees out of this. I think we're, oops. Come on, lay down flat. Okay. There we go. Oh, neither have I, Rain. Well, none today. But I'll let you know how they are. Coolio. Okay. Yeah, that's cool. That's what I wanted. Believe it or not, that is what I wanted. And I really don't want to wipe this up for my third one, so I'm just going to add purple to it. I don't know how. I'll let you know. I'll let you know in Costa Rica. I will post pictures. Oops. Oops. Oop. You know, just a dabble, do you, by the way? Not what I'm doing. Oops. Come back here. Jelly plate. I'm just going to just get some white in there. Okay. All right. This was so fun. I'm going to do it again. Oops. All right. Cool. Oh, one more piece of paper. Now, I really hope this idea works after all this bloody work, because otherwise, this makes great background paper. Oops. Great, great background paper. Ooh, that one's a little dark. Let's do one more.
That one's a little dark.
That one's a little dark. That's because I have so much purple on there. See, this white will show up. I forget. Ooh, that's a cool. All right. Let's do just a shade of this. And just a shade of this. And then I'm not doing anymore. I will make sure to have one for everybody on this group. I don't know what Tracy Vacation Girl is like. I don't have too many of them. All right, let's do this. Again, I didn't need this to be perfect. I'm just really into it, and it's really fun. Oh, perfect. That's kind of cool. See, that's what I wanted. Okay. And I kind of wanted them three different shades. And then you do want to take care of your jelly plate. And I know you can, I just wipe mine off. You can do negatives and positives and all this other crap. But I have them in several sizes, and I love them. And I do a ton of backgrounds with them. But I know people can just make awesome works of art. Awesome, awesome works of art. Where did I put the... Hold on. I just would like to, oops, first, oh, you don't want the paint to get underneath it. It'll get discolored, but it doesn't matter. See, giant yellow shot. I'm sure that's how they advertise it. And while that is sitting here, you can dry these. I'm going to cut these out, though, so I'm going to just dry this real quick. Yeah, the baby ones are cute. And then I'm going to try and cut these out so they look like Christmas trees. Wish me luck. Oops, maybe you shouldn't put it on a wet surface if you want to dry it off. So if you order the pigment acrylics or the fluid acrylics, they're full of pigment. A little goes a long way. And then I'm going to dry this one. Yeah, that's kind of what I wanted. Oh, they're fun. So this is just a deli paper or rice paper that I use. It's really thin. It's almost like tracing paper. That's what I'm using right now. This is my third one. I don't know which one. Oh, I just dropped one. Just want to make sure they're dry because it'll be easier to cut up. Here we go. Now, I'm not going to be exact with this. Where is my scissors? I'm not going to be at all with it if I don't find a pair of scissors. Okay. And I'm going to cut them out like Christmas trees, right? That's what I said I was going to do. I literally didn't measure this one. I just want like three different sizes. Okay. Guess I didn't need to make this many of them, huh? All right, there's one. Oh, Christmas tree. So this might be the only thing you guys see me do all year for Christmas because I'm really not a Christmas person. I mean, I am. I'm just... Here we go. Here is the next one that I will be... cutting up. I need a big one, I think. Okay. I need some more. That is like a drunk Christmas tree. Hold on. I don't like that one. I cut it crooked or something. Well, I have this joke with my girlfriend. Like, I'll call her and I'll say, hey, what are you doing? Good, best girlfriend, you know. Oh, nothing. Jim and I are just sitting under the Christmas tree having a glass of wine. I'm always like, I always say to her, it's really weird that I think of you and Jim, like, crouched under the Christmas tree, just wrapped around it like the Grinch, you know, watching or having a drink. Anyway, it's pretty funny. That's my. Okay, there we go. And there we go. Does that look Christmassy yet? Okay, hold on. One big fat one. One big one. Oops. It helps if I cut this one. I cut this way. You see, it's cool because I really don't care that much about them. And they're not supposed to be exact. They're just... Oh my god. This is what was in my head. If this was really works, and they really do look like Christmas trees, we're going to be really golden, aren't we? Okay. And then I need a little bit of... I'm running out of paintbrushes over here. Okay. A little bit of white. Can't get enough of this bubble wrap. I just want to bubble wrap a little bit more in here because it didn't really show up. Oops. There we go. There we go. Perfecto. Ooh. Somebody just said the bubble wrap part looks like, okay. I kind of just want them just there. They're just oddball Christmas trees, right? Nothing. No, oh, and you know what? I need to have little stems on them that need to be like, I don't know, yeah, gold, gold. That's what I'll do. In fact, I'll just color this gold. Look at this. Nothing goes to waste. All right, and then I just get rid of all of that, and then I'll just, you know what I'll do is I'll just take the brayer. Okay, let's just brayer this. I'll just brayer this on. Ooh. Whoa. There we go. Am I even in the... You're gonna let this dry. I'm just making a bigger mess than I had before. All right. Good. These are gonna be little stems. Okay, I don't know. Now we're going to just matte medium that down, and those are going to be our trees. And that is going to be as simple as this is going to be. And then, okay, all right. I'm going to make some little, these are just stems. That's what these were. But I need to paint them more goldy. Oops, that's not gold. We're running out of paintbrushes, people. There we go. I didn't need to brayer that. Just needed to paint it. I'm going to Vegas this weekend. Isn't that exciting? All right. Here we go. These are gonna, I'm gonna actually like kinda I don't want these trunks are out of hand. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. I don't need giant trunks. They're just little trunks. Whoop. Oh yeah. I feel, you know what I feel like I'm doing is like paper dolls right now. Did anybody ever have paper dolls as a kid? It's like I'm cutting them and I'm taking a little. There we go. That kind of looks cool. That's kind of what I had. There you go. Oh my God, rain. Oh my goodness, it's so great. Oh, isn't it? You're going in a couple weeks. And you know what? I'm going to take a little bit of that Queen Gold that we were just talking about and... I am going this just for a little mini getaway to go see a concert. My husband kind of surprised me with that. Okay. Sorry, I'm almost painting like out of the thing, so you really can't see. So I'm just taking some Quinn Gold here and I'm just adding it to that trunk. And that is just giving me a little bit of, we were just talking about Quinn Gold, see? And I'm just giving myself a little bit of a, just a little bit of color. Just aging those bad boys, because they were just solid gold trunks, and I don't know if you know this, but a lot of Christmas trees don't have solid gold trunks, but in Tracy Land they do. All right, we are ready to decoupage this on, and we are not going to care how we decoupage this. We're going to just matte medium it. Where is my matte medium? Okay, bring it back. So we are going to just matte medium like we just don't care. Got to find a brush though. And then I'm going to put the word joy on it. I just don't know how I'm going to put the word joy. And then I'm going to distress the edges a little bit. And I'm going to call it a day. I'm going to call it a big, fat day. I'm not going to worry about this. I'm not going to worry about placement. That is for another show. This was to keep it light and airy. That's all I said this was going to be. Light and airy. Right? And that's what I promised. Here's one tree. Okay. See, that's the cool thing about decoupage. And see, all these are matte medium. It's just, it's a sealer. It's a glue. It's a sealer. Okay. Just make sure you get, you know, we got a lot of texture going on with this. But we're going to go around the edges of it, so I'm not even that concerned with it. Okay. Then we are going to, so we're just going to matte medium the crap out of this. Okay. We're going to just matte medium this. And then we're going to just matte medium. So we got to get this giant tree on here. And we don't know where it's going to go yet. Where it's going to go, nobody knows. Okay. This is what, see, and this is almost, like, with the paper being see-through, it's kind of cool. And I'll hold it up. Oops. We just got to make sure our tree stays good. Oh! We lost a Houston. We lost a stem. Now, keep in mind, if you have scrapbook paper, you could be doing the same thing with scrapbook paper, okay? Okay. There we go. How are we doing? Is everybody still? All right. I don't even know how I'm doing on time, but I don't care because this is the most creative I have felt in weeks. Oh, that's a draw. Okay. And if anybody emails me or texts me right now, I really can't hang to my phone because my fingers are full of matte medium. All right, there we go. Now, you're all probably wondering, why can't she just do this when she's crafting by herself? But no, it's really hard. I really love it that we're just sitting here doing this, but I encourage you when you are creating like this, just, oh shoot, don't spill your matte medium. My God, the lid was on. Just paint as if you don't care and somebody is watching, because it's kind of cool. Now you got to get all this matte medium dry. All right. Oh, yes. I really like this. I really like this page. This is about as Christmassy as you'll ever see me get. And I'm kind of feeling it. What do you think? Are we good? Uh-oh. Oh, good. I'm still on. Oh, my God. Woo! I thought it was not on anymore. I can probably get rid of this 12 pairs of scissors with it laying next to me. Get my work surface back here. And I will list all the colors I use. I'm going to do this, too. I'm going to wipe my background because I'm kind of working on a very wet surface, just a dirty surface. That doesn't help me either. So just give me 1 second of cleanup. 1 second. So I kind of like to clean up a little bit just because I don't want the back of my paper to get all smushy with bad stuff. And that, if you guys didn't order the brush cleaner, jump back into your register and get the brush cleaner, because you are going to love, love, love it. That's what I'm wiping everything up with, including my hands. That's brush cleaner. Okay, and I will list every color and everything I use. Oh, my God. Oh, I feel back. All right. I don't know how back I am, if it'll stay, but it's here. What does Olivia think? I need the Olivia seal of approval. And I even do this a little bit on my, but I don't worry about my brayer. Don't ever worry about your brayer. All right. Everything will go up on my website with the colors, and I will list, when I do my art journal, I list the colors on my art journal. So I didn't use that. Good. Okay, good. Now we're back to working on a clean surface. I can breathe again. Everybody can go back to your normal feeling good about things. I like the texture too. My mojo would be back. It is. Oh, I'm not as bad as Bonnie just said. Thank you, Bonnie, for coming to my defense. I've had some pretty messy nights. Now, I am going to take, I have these foam stamps. I don't want to put stars on the top of that because that just seems like such a lot of work. Okay, so I'm going to do these snowflakes. I'm just going to do one. Oh, do I have these? Are all too big. No, I'm just going to do this snowflake on the top in white. I'm just making sure this is dry. Okay, Olivia likes the texture. Good. Kind of need to make sure that this is dry, but I'm going to take some. This is where I was talking about the Prussian blue hue. I love Prussian blue hue. And I'm going to take a dry brush. I'm going to find a dry spot on my palette. These come from the Dollar Tree, so I just dump them, if you're wondering. I order, oh, hold on, let me get the dried up gunk off the cover. And that way it'll come out. All right, so this is what I was talking about, the Prussian blue hue being my favorite. Put that upside down because I'm running out of it. Dry brush. I've had the same dry brush for 52 years. Okay, and I'm going to, I'm just, so Prussian blue hue is gonna give it this lovely, a little too much over here, but see, again, we've used matte medium, so if you get too much, you can just pull it back, because remember, matte medium is a lovely sealer. Okay, so let's work where everybody can see you working, and let's keep going with Prussian blue hue. Oh my gosh, speaking of Andy Skinner, if anybody's taking my CHA workshop, be prepared. Or any, if you're coming to CHA, I am ready. So Andy Skinner, if you are watching the rerun of this, you had better watch yourself. Oh, speaking of that, I need you guys. I need you guys. December 9th, it's a Wednesday at noon, and you don't even have to be present to win this one because we're going to do another blab. I need you to go to my blog, Andy or Angie, could you please give the link? Now see, by dry brushing this on, and this is Prussian blue hue. See, it's a blue. So Angie, will you go to my Andy Skinner blab announcement? It should be like a post or two down. I need you guys to go post a comment. We're doing three giveaways. The first giveaway is going to be announced minutes after we go on air. And it is going to be, we're going to pick one of our favorite questions, but you got to go to my blog and post a question. So I would love for you guys, anything you want to ask Andy Skinner or myself, if you can keep it clean, great. If you can't, we'll still probably answer it. And if you can join us live, it's Blab. All you need is a Twitter account. It's free. You can just watch us directly on the internet, and we both come to you from our studios. And we're doing a third one from CHA, which will be USA time, and I can't remember. I listed the days and the times. So this is just a dry brush. And then when you get too much or you're concentrated in an area you don't want it, pull it back. Okay? What do you think of that? So I'm asking if you could all just go do that. That would be so lovely because within the first couple of minutes is the first giveaway and we're just picking our favorite comment. So how easy is it the prizes are very cool. We always give cool stuff away. Ask Pam. Pam's prize is on her way. Okay. Thank you, Angie, for stepping up and helping me so much. All right. This is a Stabilo grease pencil. And I will list this. Don't worry. I'll write it down. It's a, what is it called? Aquarella, I think. Stabilo. Aquarellable. And you got to have it somewhat sharp. Okay. Done. Even added a question. Angie has entered. Bingo. Doesn't, you know, it doesn't have to be great. Oh, ooh, this is so wet that this is not a great idea. Okay, so we'll do it this way. I am going to, I will use that, but yeah, this is better. Okay, I will use the, I prefer to use that, but this is all still wet, and so I gotta be careful because, like, my tree's coming up there, see. Let's get some more matte medium underneath that. All right, I got a little, I gotta do a little surgery right there. You do want your tree to be stuck down. But see, that's the good part about matte medium. You can just go back and... All right. So what I'm going to do is I am going to outline and blend. And this is a Uniball... No, what is this thing? This is a... this is a food ball. It is a... But it, see, it is activated by, see me just wetting my finger. So what you want to make sure is that you seal this with a spray sealer before you use a brush-on sealer, because you will just wipe this bad boy away because it's activated by water. So I will spray seal this, of course. And I'm going to add the word joy. I don't know, something. I don't know how I'm going to add it, though. I haven't really gotten that far. But I don't think the really the learning is in my words. The learning is in the techniques we did tonight, which was, okay, so would you please go do that, because I would like to see some cool questions. We will be just talking all things mixed media. You could ask us anything. Just don't ask me what I'm doing to pay Andy Skinner back at... Oh, I can't tell you when I'm paying him back, but trust me, you'll see it all over Facebook. And I cannot wait. I ordered it today. That is so nifty. Okay. Okay, Angie just said, I totally want to make this page tomorrow. If you decide to do anything having to do like this, because post it on our Facebook group. Okay, so this, I'm going to have the words joy in mine. I don't know. I haven't decided how I'm going to put it on there. This is great. This is not, I still have time. Oh my God, 7:06. I'm totally rushing as if I'm a mad woman. I want to add some doodly-doos or something on the side of this. I don't want to... My words are going to be, like, right across here. And I'm not going to worry about... Oh, two questions. Perfect! Oh, my goodness. Okay. The more questions, the better. But we're picking our favorite question. It's going to be the first question we answer. And we get to decide what that is. Okay, I'm just taking... I'm taking a little bit of white paint here. I'm just using Americana right here because I want it to be kind of thick. Where is my... I'm running out of brushes. All right, this is just a foam stamp. Nothing major. I'm just going to... Ooh. I want something to be at the top of these, and I don't know what else I have, and I don't probably have some small stars somewhere, but I don't care. Okay. Cool. Good. That is good. See, look at me and my whole winter theme. Take that, people. Okay. I want a little more something, something. I can't wait to talk about my stamps, just to tell you the truth. It's so hard to have a secret Because I really just like to blab to you guys and just talk, 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 talk. But I'm really excited about my stamps. I really am excited about them. They are very cool. Very cool. Okay. So this is just something I've had forever, and now it has like 1,000 bits of paint in it. But I don't care. Paint it like you just don't care, because that's what we're doing tonight. But anyway, as soon as I can give you the rundown on my stamp... Oh, I did not want that brush. Okay. What brush do I want? I'm going to do like a stencil brush. So this is a little bit of Payne's Gray in this thing. Oh, yeah. I almost want black. Do I have black? Of course I have carbon black. Who doesn't have carbon black? So like I said, just the littlest dab. Oh my goodness, I needed tonight. Oh, did I need tonight? I have just been staring at pieces of paper for... All right. See, sometimes you just gotta paint like people are watching. Hold on, I'm just trying to line that up. I don't know why. Because I'm being a crazy perfectionist. All right. I need that to be darker. Okay. Oh, yeah. I need some more in here. Too perfect. This is turning out, and I haven't decided yet how I have not decided how I'm going to put the words on, but there's going to be words. Oh, that's a little too perfect. All right, and then I'm going to go back to my Prussian blue hue because it made me so happy with my very dry brush. And make sure your brush is dry and not full of black paint. Okay. All right, I am just going at this like crazy. I don't even know which one's Prussian blue hue anymore, but I think we're done. I think we got it. What do you think? I think we're done. You know, there's a point where I just go too far, so I feel like I'm approaching the runway on that one. Okay. Did you see that? Okay, and remember that brush cleaner I told you about? Always wipe. Whoa. Always watch it go across your painting. Always wipe your stipple brushes. Don't run those underwater. You can order these from DecoArt, too. Don't run them underwater. They're just not good for the barrel. I just recommend you always kind of just take a brush cleaner and do this to them. Heck, you can clean your table, see, while you're doing it. And that's all you need to do to those. Just, otherwise the water gets up in the barrel and junks it all up. So the word joy is going to be right across here. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, that was crazy. I'm done. I don't feel like I should keep adding to this because I feel like it'll go from a mountain to a mess in about two minutes. But it's, I mean, I do think it needs a little bit more up here. But that's okay. Just, you know, I'll do something. Okay.
Oh, I'm back. Finished. You know what that needs, too? It needs a flicker of something, like some, I don't know. No, I'm going to leave it alone. I'm going to leave this alone. Because if I touch this anymore, I am bound to, no, there's just one thing I want to do. No, I'm done. Olivia is done, too. Post a picture. So this was really like tissue paper upon, and I will spray seal this up. I will spray seal it. Then I will do a varnish over the top of it, and that's just a brush-on varnish. Everybody asks me how I do that. There are four of them: soft touch satin, ultra matte, and one more, gloss. And I would probably pick. Oh, the splash. Okay, I'm splotching it. I probably will do some white and black splotches with my misters. Okay, but I won't do that live because I'm bound to mess something up. And then I'll probably do a satin on this, I would think. Maybe a matte. So, there you go. Look at that. I really like this piece. And my hair and DNA are in the one corner of it. And I'm just going to put the word joy, and I'm probably just going to cut it out of something simple, like book text. This one's not going over the top. Maybe a book text, something simple. It's only 7:14. I did that in less than an hour. See? The mojo was there all the time. Thank you, Angie, so much for tonight, too. I really appreciate it. I know this isn't the only thing in your wheelhouse right now. It sounds like a lot of people got stuff going on. So, let's see. Let's talk about next week. What is the date of next week? I'm here. I come back on Saturday. I'm here. I'm here. And then I'm talking to, I might have a guest on the, what's the date next week? Hold on. Let me look at my calendar. Okay. It is, December 7th, December 14th, I will have a guest here. Will not be here the 21st. So there are three shows, I believe, in December. And I thank you guys from the bottom of my heart that even when I think I can't step up, you make me step up. There is no sidestepping the stepping up. See that I made that up. Yes, my dad will be here. So I'm kind of planning something special that we might do like a holiday, ringing in the holidays, something. And I would ask that you guys all either via email or email. I'd love some email right now. Either via email or post on my blog a question for Andy and I. We'll be live December 9th at noon, to make sure. And we will have three giveaways. I'm thinking about it, Cindy. I'm wondering if I could rein my dad in. But I'm not telling him, so him not being here is perfect. So next week, nobody can say a word. I'm just going to ask my dad if he's game. He's probably going to kill me, but that's okay. I'll probably be in Costa Rica and he'll like harpoon me or something. So this is probably it for Christmas for me. I don't know. I might surprise you though. I have another project in mind too, but all right. So the recap will be, yeah, everybody zip it. The recap should be on my blog, hopefully tomorrow. I'm not doing anything tonight other than working and catching up and making some lifelong decisions in my studio. Lips are zipped. And, I've just got to work out the details, but I really want it to be a surprise because I know my family loves surprises. Yeah, Rain, I don't do a ton of Christmas. Normally I don't do a ton of themed items. So, all right. So I thank you so much. And I hope you guys go submit that question. And I thank you for being in my studio. Where are the kids?
Hold on.
I found one. You haven't seen this one in a long time. Just say hi.
I just took all my
makeup. Okay, you really don't wear a ton of makeup, so come on, just say hi.
Why?
Just say hi.
I'm not wearing makeup.
Say hi.
Hi.
That's one of my kiddos.
Okay. Bye.
Okay. Thank you, guys. I will see you next Monday, and hopefully my parents will be back. And thank you for joining me in Louisiana, not so dead. I hope she's still here. Okay, don't forget to join the Facebook group. I'll see you all next week. Good night.